Hey everyone, so today I'm going to be kind of telling you and not really showing you, but just telling you different techniques and different ways for different kinds of ways to curl your hair, if that made sense to any of you. So there's lots of different ways. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different ways, different types of curls, different ways you could kind of curl your hair with different, like what curling iron to use, what technique to do to achieve that look. So the first one is loose curls. The second one is like just kind of classic natural curly hair, like the one like I'm wearing right now. Then spiral curl, like ringlets, and just like wavy hair pretty much. And then the fifth one is how to look like you have naturally wavy curly hair when you don't. So how to fake it if you have straight hair. And then also how to get just kind of like stringy little voluminous curls. And I'm actually filming in my dining room today because they are pressure washing outside. So if you hear noise in the background, this room is really, really loud. So I'm going to start by telling you how to get just like loose curls, kind of like the Kardashians, and all that. I actually do not have a curling iron that would give you the best results. I believe this is a 1-inch curling iron, and this is what I use, and just because I have thin hair, it kind of gives me long curls, but and big kind of curls. But if you could find one, which you probably can, that is bigger than this, this is what you want to use. Just a plain curling iron, and all you do is curl your hair. If you want to be like the Kardashians, they kind of start lower like I'm wearing right now, and you just start lower and you curl it. You don't start up at your roots. And you just use a big one. You could hairspray it and then brush it out to give it a really soft look. To get just kind of normal, your everyday kind of curly hair, you know, like I'm wearing, it's not too big, it's not too small. You can use this kind of curling iron, but my all-time favorite curling iron, this is all I really use anymore, is this Con Air curling wand. And this was I believe it was $40 at Target. Maybe it was $30. It's $30 or $40. But I don't even use any other curling iron anymore. This will give you so many different looks just depending on how you use it. I use this for my hair today. But that will kind of give you like a natural look. This especially because it gives you more of an S curl instead of a spiral curl. This gives you more of a spiral curl. And this, just the way it's shaped, it has no clamp, so you just wrap your hair around it. I thought I would burn my fingers so much, but I don't even wear a heating glove. You can do the same thing. You could wrap your hair around just a normal curling iron. And this is a Gilberry, and so you could just wrap your hair around it. But with this one, I actually wear a glove. I don't know why, it's just how I do it. But I would totally recommend this. It's so easy. People think curling your hair is like, it takes so much time and everything, but this look that I'm wearing right now only took me a couple more minutes than straightening my hair would, so it's about the same pretty much, and I absolutely love this curling iron. The next thing is for spirals and ringlets, and if you want ringlets, I would definitely recommend a normal curling iron. One, this one will give you pretty good, depending on how big of sections you take. If you want more full kind of waves and smaller, tighter curls, you need to take small sections. I took pretty big sections, and so like this was one section right here, and that's a pretty big piece of hair, because I didn't want tight curls. I just wanted it to be kind of loose and natural. But if you want spirals, you just take smaller pieces and you have to hold it a lot longer. You could do the same thing with this, but this isn't going to give you like a perfect spiral, whereas this will, because the other curling wand gives you kind of a, sorry about that, but the curling wand kind of gives you like an S curl, so it's more natural, more like a normal, like a naturally curly hair. I don't know how to say what I'm trying to say. And then the next look is, if you have straight hair like I do, if you've seen my How to Train Your Hair video, my hair looks super curly, and if you saw me in person, it looked like I had naturally curly hair almost. And it was just really full and just really curly all the way up at the roots and everything, a lot of volume and all that. And to do that, I use this. So it's kind of funny how you could get super curly hair with this, and you could also get kind of just, you know, everyday hair with this. So what I did for that is you want to start up, up, up at your root. And what I actually do is I take small pieces in a bunch of layers. This I did, I just separated my hair, bottom half and top half. For that, I did like the bottom, then another layer, then another layer, then another layer, and then the top. So I did a lot more layers and a lot smaller pieces to get that kind of naturally curly hair look. With this, what I do is I curl it, and then I come up to the top and recurl it. So I would have it like up here, and then I would just go like that, just to give it some extra volume. And also, if you want your hair just to look more natural, mine, as I don't know if you could tell, it all goes this way. I curled both sides away from my face. Now, to get it more natural, like I did in that one video, which I will do a tutorial on that one because a lot of people ask me, but the pieces framing your face, you curl away, and then you alternate for the rest of your hair, and it just kind of mixes all together and it looks a lot more natural and not like you actually curled your hair. So that's a trick for that as well. And then to get like the stringy kind of curls, almost like Miley Cyrus or something, I actually did a tutorial on that if you want to go check out my older videos. I used this curling iron and I curled my hair. You don't let, while it's still hot, you pull down on it so it like loosens some of the curls, and then you hairspray it and run your fingers through it, and that's the best way I found. It's kind of hard to do that, and you don't leave it, you only curl it for a few seconds and you let it go, and you kind of like pull it down as you go. And just to get kind of wavy hair, like beachy hair, I guess, I would use something like this, which is a waver, and this one is from Golden Hot. And this isn't a crimper. A crimper is a lot more harsh, but this actually has like barrels, so it gives you that more round kind of flowy look. And you basically just go down all your, like, you just clamp, 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 clamp all the way down, and you take different sections, different size sections, and this will give you just kind of wavy hair. Kind of like it gives you the same effect as if you braid it the night before and then you take out the braid. That's what it does. So I hope you guys learned something. I hope this helped some of you guys. For each one of those six things that I mentioned, I will post like an example of kind of what I'm talking about in the info box down below. I'll find a picture and I'll just be like loose curls, and I'll put a picture so you guys kind of know what I'm talking about if you want to go back and all that. So yeah, I'll see you guys soon. Bye.